Today's teams will do battle for the rights to the Purdue Cannon, which made its inaugural trip to Champaign in 1905. This coin toss presented by Nissan, innovation that excites. Purdue has lined up for the kickoff, and we're ready to get this one underway. Gathered in at the 6. And he's tackled at the 25. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today.
Here we go, Pete, get off the field. Like 5, right there, 5.
Quick strike to the receiver, and down he goes at about the 25-yard line. Some open field up the middle for a nice game.
I don't even know why this team showed up.
Hey, check right, check right.
Hey, kill, kill, kill.
Throws it in a hurry. Tackle made right around the 38-yard line.
To get good yards here on the screen pass, the running back needs to have patience. And that was on display right here. He waited for his blockers and picked up good yards.
He's at midfield, fires out to his wideout. He's knocked down of bounds at the 47.
I like it. They're not afraid to try this defense over the middle. The quarterback saw man coverage and gave his receiver a chance to make a play. They picked up the first down. I wouldn't be surprised to see them come back to that play.
He's going left. From the 47-yard line, second down. Down at the 44-yard line.
Larry, Larry.
Kill, 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 kill.
Quick throw to the back, it's incomplete.
You know, sometimes the toughest throws to make for a quarterback is when he has a wide receiver wide open, and everybody in the stands is saying, throw it, throw it. And you aim the football instead of just getting back in rhythm, stepping, and throwing. And that time, he aimed the ball, and it was incomplete.
The Boilermakers and their coaching staff, Kirk, just happy to have a guy like this in the program. Their offense really clicks when he's playing well.
Well, I think it gives them the diversity that they're looking for. I mean, at times they're going to run the football. Other times they're going to try to air it out. And when you have one guy that gets so much attention on the outside, it just seems to open up other aspects of their offensive attack. And they've done a good job.
Crosses left. Intercepted. He's taken down around the 25-yard line.
He seemed a little hesitant on that throw. And that left the defender time to break on the ball and pick it off.
Kirk, we got a player down, obviously in some pain. First and 10. Ball on the 25. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He throws it. He goes up, picked off.
The defense really cranked up the heat there. Give those guys all the credit for forcing a desperation pass.
From their own 9-yard line, first down. Good open field tackle. At the 19-yard line.
Larry, Larry.
Come on, I'm up. Larry,
tackled after D. decent pickup.
You know, Brad, on these third downs where it's third and medium, it gives the play caller a chance to run the football or to throw the football. In this case, I really think the defense was sitting back thinking about more the pass game, and it opened up some running lanes, and the offense was able to take advantage of that and convert for a first down.
Tackled right around the 26-yard line.
Super job here by the defense of filling the gaps on the line. If you keep stringing out plays like that, you can really shut an option attack down.
It's third and eight. Ball on their own 26.
Irby, this guy headed to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury. We don't know how bad it is, but right now it doesn't look like he's likely to play any more football.
Brought down quickly. It'll be short of the first after the completion.
Well, good effort by the defense to make sure they got him before he got to the marker.
Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
Well, it's just a defensive battle so far, Kirk.
Well, it's a combination of a couple of things, Brad. I think the defenses are playing well, but I think the offenses at this point are making it a little bit easier for them. So let's see if these offenses can get it going a little bit to try to challenge these defenses.
Quarterback couldn't maintain possession on their last drive. Let's see what he does here.
He can't dwell on the interception. There's still a whole lot of football to be played today.
Receiver incomplete.
There's one the quarterback would like to rewind because he has a wide open receiver and he just misfires.
Third down now, and they need to get it out to the 50.
Red two.
They looked a little sluggish on that series. I'm curious to see if they pick things up when they get the ball back.
Moore awaiting the return. Tackle at the 26. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Got it and brought down immediately. Run up the middle. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. Down he goes at the 36. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. Quick throw, almost intercepted.
This quarterback has got to do a better job of looking off defenders and allow his covered receivers some room to improvise and get free.
From their own 36-yard line, it's second down. Gets rid of it quickly. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 47-yard line.
I think a key in being able to throw a good screen pass is the quarterback selling, looking downfield as if he's going to throw the ball downfield, knowing he's about to retreat and just dump it to his running back. So I think the quarterback is the key, being able to time it up wait for that pressure to get to him, and then wait to the last possible second to deliver the football to the receiver or running back.
And he hits him hard at the 33-yard line. Fights forward to about the 26.
Roger.
Kill.
He's into the open field. Gets out to around the 15. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 15. Stop behind the line.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
And this is the 10th play of the drive.
I got number 18. I got you, 18.
Defensive coordinator anticipating this five wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. Fires it out. They'll bring him down at the 17. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. And he's taken down at the 8. This should be an easy field goal. Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
Maybe he got the cadence wrong coming out of the huddle. The coaches have a low threshold for mistakes like that.
Illinois could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and it is good. McCourt gets set to kick this one away. It's fielded at the 2. Brought down at the 28. Illinois' defense is playing lights out right now and pitching a shutout.
Yeah, I would not be shocked at all to see this defense be able to maintain this. Just the way they're playing, the attitude that they seem to be playing with, if they can maintain the energy and the awareness of this offense, there's a very good shot that they could shut this offense out.
Fires that quickly to the tailback. That's a great tackle at the 34. Almost 6 yards on the play action.
The defense here let the halfback roam free for a second, and they were able to connect for a short gain on the play.
Pitch out, got the corner. He takes it right side for a good gain. This game's already shaping up to be a good one as we head to the second quarter. 3-0, Fighting Illini. We can only hope the second quarter's as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks.
Mike 35.
And he throws it away. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 40. And he's tackled around the 43-yard line. Hit and taken down.
Don't change.
He lets it go. Tipped away.
Surprising to me that the secondary was in such good position. I thought the play call had him fooled at first, but a nice play by the D.
From the 47-yard line, it's second down. He's going to go for the home run. Scramble, and he's going to run this one in. Touchdown. A short burst for the score.
That's what happens when you can win the war in the trenches down near the goal line.
He makes the PAT. An 8-play, 72-yard drive, and they get it in for 7. They line up to kick this one away. He'll take it from the 2. Across the 30. Taken down by the kicker.
I think this defense has played well enough to be able to win this game, obviously, but at some point, you'd love to see their own offense feed off of some of the confidence that their defense is playing with, because up to this point, the defense is keeping them in the game, but the offense isn't quite doing enough to be able to build on that lead.
He's on the run. Runs right for a nice game. It into coverage, and it's intercepted.
This safety always seems to be in the right place at the right time. It's no surprise that he comes up with the interception here.
First and 10, ball on the 48-yard line. Purdue holds a 4-point lead. Makes the catch, and look out, and they make the stop at about the 39-yard line.
Tight end right. Tight end right. Three down.
Check regular.
Check 52.
Deep ball, laying it out there. It's knocked away, incomplete. From the 39-yard line. Second down. Complete. He's got room.
Excellent execution on one side of the ball that time. And it looks to me like the defense was in a little state of confusion. Let's see if they can pull themselves together.
Tackled right away. Fires quickly, and he's got his receiver for the touchdown. Hits the PAT. A 5-play, 51-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
So the score now, 14-3. From the 7, he's taken down at the 34-yard line. You know the offense will be looking to do better this time out.
If they can play sound football from here out and make a few plays, there's no reason they can't get back into this.
Coming after you.
level at the 47. Nice run, and he's brought down. A 4-yard gain by the halfback on the option. Makes it out to about the 26. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
Up the middle for a nice gain. Down around the 10-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 10-yard line. Run inside. Stop quickly. Run there. Tackle made around the 6-yard line.
We'll give the defense all the credit here. They had that one snuffed out from the start. It could have been an even bigger loss.
This one should be makeable. Might have been some early movement up front.
Once you're set, you've got to stay that way. The slightest flinch is going to be enough to draw the flag.
And they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. He gets it up, and it sails through the uprights. Ready to kick. He's to the 20. At the 30. They'll bring him down at the 33. Last drive ended with as good a result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator has got to be delivered. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
Purdue holds an 8-point advantage. Throws complete. He's hammered. Steps up in the pocket and sacked. Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 45. Play across the middle. And down he goes, right around the 46-yard line. He'll try to knock this punt down inside the 20. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback.
This offense is just going to be kicking themselves. They're moving the ball very well. In fact, they're getting into their opponent's territory. The only problem is they're not finishing off the drives with touchdowns. They're having to settle for field goals. That could eventually catch up to them.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. He's tackled at the 29. Illinois will take their first time out of the half. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Fires out to his receiver. He's taken down at the 36-yard line. And he throws right away. Got it. Complete. He's out of bounds.
It's a nice job here by the wide receiver of looking the ball in and keeping the chains moving. He was on the same page as his quarterback as they both saw the double outside linebacker blitz coming.
From the 46-yard line, first down. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. Fires, stays in bounds, and made a nice catch. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. Illinois is going to have to use their second time out of the half. It's the ninth play of the drive.
And two, yellow, three.
He makes it to the 18-yard line.
Hey, kill, kill, kill.
Anytime you can prevent a third down conversion, you're doing something right. Solid coverage.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. There was some movement on the line.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
Kicks away. And he missed it off the upright. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Purdue up by eight. Going deep. Right around the 38-yard line. So what do you think of this receiver after that play?
The quarterback made a nice throw, but it was the receiver who made this happen. That's a great way to make a statement.
Let's it fly. And it's going the other way. It's the senior corner.
The defense really cranked up the heat there. Give those guys all the credit for forcing a desperation pass.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 20. He chucks it downfield. Doesn't get there.
Brady drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
They'll bring him down right around the 30.
You know, the offense dug themselves such a big hole on this series that they come up short here on third down. This is a nice run on third down and long. The problem is they have so far to go to pick up a first down that they bring up the fourth down.
He gets out to about the 38-yard line.
Decent effort. He's not the type of guy to call a fair catch very often. He does have the ability to make guys miss.
The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
So they decide to bring the kicker out to try to get 3 points before the half ends. Purdue is up by 8. It's up. And this one doesn't have the distance. And watch out, because they can return this. And he's taken down around the 25-yard line. Well, we're headed to halftime now, and we're seeing two defenses that don't want to give an inch. Purdue's up by 8.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. I'm sure both teams had problems in the first half, but one of them, David, not moving the football. Both offenses really ran up and down the field.
We see this more in college football, Reese. More success on the offensive side, and it's harder and harder to stop these offenses that continue to get more and more complicated. The defenses, they got no answer. They got to find an answer quick, or else this ball game is just going to go tick for tack the whole second half.
Just about set to start the second half. What are you looking for?
I'm looking to see which team has that decided schematical advantage.
And if they can find it, they'll blow holes 3 or 4 axe handles wide. Brad and Kirk will be there to call the second half.
All right, Reese and David, welcome back, everybody. Just about set to start the second half. Moore from the 6. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. And he throws it away. From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Fires complete over the middle. And he's tackled at about the 41. Purdue holds an 8-point advantage. Quick throw, and they make the stop at about the 47-yard line. The sub package in there defensively in this 5 wide receiver set. Flushed out, and he's going to get sacked.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you're definitely going to feel it the next day.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. They come out in an empty backfield. Moves up, and the defense has got it. So the sack makes this third and very long. Quick throw. He's hit and taken down. Throw to the tight end. Brought down right around the 22-yard line.
Tight end right. Tight end right.
Purdue up by 8. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. Positive yardage. Throws complete. He's got space to work.
They're giving away 3 yards and only making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
It's first down, and they'll bring it up first and goal inside the 5. It's power against power right now on the field. Both teams have their jumbo sets out there. Passes to the right. It's picked off. Great catch by the linebacker, but not a smart throw from the quarterback.
It didn't look like the quarterback even saw the linebacker hanging in that area. It pays to be in the right spot at the right time.
From their own 11-yard line, first down. Hands it to the back. They'll knock him down for a loss.
The offensive line needs to do a better job of not only handling the defensive linemen, but getting up to the linebackers. That way the ball carriers will have a little bit more room to get to that second level.
And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. A pickup of 4 on the play.
You don't have to throw it deep to have success. Any sort of completion can help boost an offense's confidence.
Balance throw got him anywhere, and he is drilled at the 19. Hayes is waiting for the snap. He really got a hold of that one. He makes it out to midfield. Purdue's coaching staff's got to be excited. Their game plan was to get it in this guy's hands, and they've done a great job of it.
Well, they've done a really good job of getting the football, and they've come up with a variety of ways of putting the ball in his hands. And I think you combine the scheme with this young man's abilities, it's no wonder he's having such a big game.
He fights forward to about the 49. Purdue is up by 8. Here's the halfback on the screen. Knocked out of bounds at the 48. Pass complete and taken down immediately. This punt, if he gets it where he wants, it can really change the field position in this football game. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He gets to about the 31-yard line. Intercepted, and down he goes at the 33-yard line. That penalty will move him back a bit.
Yeah, and with so many young guys out there, it's bound to happen occasionally.
First and 10, ball on the 19-yard line. Gets to about the 17-yard line. 2-yard carry by the fullback. He tackles him for a loss. Third and 11 here. Ball on the 20. Purdue holds an 8-point advantage. Quick throw. Touchdown, Boilermakers. That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. With a three-play, 19-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. So the score now, 21-6. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He's to the 20. Across the 30. Tackle at the 33.
The Boilermakers continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. He makes his way to about the 42.
Roger, roger! Mike 55. Eat.
Easy, 2. Green 15. 20.
And he tackles him hard at the 50-yard line. He's at the 40. He's tackled at the 34. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. Makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
Check three.
Steps out of bounds at the 14. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Taken down at the 6. He's in for the score, and they're back in it. And he adds the extra point.
the court as the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. He's to the 20. He's tackled at the 30-yard line. The offense will come out again hoping to have similar results as their last drive.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing and how to attack the defense. And right now, these wide receivers clearly have done an outstanding job in being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterback put the ball right on the money.
Purdue up by 8. Caught out in the open. Tackle around the 42-yard line. Run up the middle.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't want none. They don't want none of this.
Let's go! Thunder!
Gets rid of it quickly. They'll bring him down right around the 18-yard line. Game so far, and it looks like it'll be decided in the fourth. 21-13, Purdue. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Gets out to about the 21. A bullet. Throws to the receiver, got it for the touchdown. And for Plummer, he gets his third touchdown pass of the game.
He's been letting it fly today, and his receivers are making plays. That is a great touchdown.
And he tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the 6. He's out to the 30, and he's taken down at the 32.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer, and that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
Both sides have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry, and he's taken down around the 40-yard line. Run to the outside. And he hits him hard at the 44-yard line. He might have a chance. And he carries the ball for a nice game. He makes it to the 35-yard line.
Check, check.
they get nice yardage on that run. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Makes it to the 21. This is the eighth play of this drive. Well, after that injury, we'll get to see the backup quarterback here. Grabs it and hammered right there. Catches it, and he's punished.
Hey, I'm coming.
Hey, check right.
Fires quickly, and he's got his man. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. The middle, caught it, touchdown. So the kicker's going to stay on the sidelines. These guys will try for a two-point conversion. They go with a run, and he's taken down behind the line. It was an 11-play, 69-yard drive, but they just get 6 points after failing to convert for two.
You know, Brad, a lot of times you have to watch practice and watch a 7-on-7 drill to not see the ball touch the ground. But this time, they went the entire length of the field. The ball never touched the ground. Great execution by the quarterback and the receiver.
They'll bring him down at the 32-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And they make the stop around the 35-yard line. Makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. And he's tackled at about the 37-yard line. Drive ended with as good a result as you can hope for, and I'm sure they'd like to replicate that here.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And the one thing is that any defensive coordinator will tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
He's out of bounds at the 46-yard line. There's a strike complete. He's tackled in the open field. Just under three to go in regulation. Fires out to his receiver. He steps out at the 43.
Kill.
Caught and out of bounds after a short game.
Hightower picks up 7 yards with that catch.
Nice protection, a good pass, and even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He took the snap and he threw it right out there. After review, they decided that the call on the field will stand. It to the outside. Tackle made at the 13-yard line.
It's a nice job here by the wide receiver of looking the ball in and keeping the chains moving. He was on the same page as his quarterback as they both saw the double outside linebacker blitz come.
He throws it. Throws quickly into the end zone. Caught for the touchdown. He makes the PAT. So a 7-play, 62-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
This quarterback has really demonstrated a tremendous amount of ability and leadership today. I'd be very surprised if he didn't continue to play well.
And he'll return this one from the 7. He's taken down at the 36-yard line. Flag on the play. Let's see what it is.
Frustrating for a coach when you preach fundamentals every week and then have someone called for clipping. That penalty really is going to set them back.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Just over 2 minutes in the game. Brought down around the 24-yard line.
The quarterback and his receiver make a great play here and convert on an early down.
It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Gets it. He's in space. And he's level at the 33-yard line. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here. And the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
Setting up blockers. The running back's got it on the screen. And down he goes around the 41-yard line. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
Slings it out and it gets tipped.
You know, the safety's responsibility, Brad, is to always make sure nothing is going to get behind him. He cannot ever get beat deep. But also he has a responsibility to step up and make a play on the football in front of him. It's just another example of a defensive back, in this case a safety, just having really good instinct to be able to come up and know when to come up to knock that ball away.
From their own 44-yard line, it's first down.
In your face. 35's
the mic. Ready. 35.
They bring him down in the backfield.
You know, a lot of times coaches look to linebackers for leadership on defense. And on that tackle, he showed you why that's the case.
Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line.
The option can be really tough to defend. At that time, it was well played by the defense.
This one's in the books. The Boilermakers get the win, 28-26. Let's get Kirk Herbstreit's final thoughts on this one. Herbie, what do you got for us?
Nothing adds to the pageantry of college football more than a good rivalry. This was a great game that should only add more fuel to the fire for next year's matchup. And boy, was it fun to watch.
So that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.